Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters in the Lord. Once again, your usual host, Mrs. Evangelist Egwuma. I bless you all in the name of Jesus. I just want to quickly give a word of exhortation, which I titled, Stop Counting on Insinuations. I repeat, stop counting on insinuations. Praise the Lord, somebody. I thank God for your life. As you just quickly tune on, as I'm about giving the word of God, but first and foremost, let us pray. Heavenly Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, once again, I thank you for a moment like this, for your grace upon our life to see this day, to see this moment. My Lord and my Savior, as many that look, luckily just tune on right now, as your word is about to come, I pray, Lord, you open their head and open their hearts and give them that understanding that whatever I will speak through my mouth, may I not speak of my own, every spirit of distraction that will make me not to give a good word of exhortation, I render them impotent. And I pray for my viewers all over the world that whatever they are going to hear from Mrs. Evangelist Egwuma is not my word, rather is the word of God. Father, bet on your word, use your word. Let as many that will hear the sound of my voice be quickened by the power of your word. At the end, you alone will take all the glory. For in Jesus' name I have prayed, amen. Thank you, viewers all over the world. Once again, I thank you for being on your way, for listening to the sound of Mrs. Evangelist Egwuma. The voice of Mrs. Evangelist Egwuma is not my word, it's just a word of God. I'm here to encourage you. One word for God, one word from God will change you, will make things turn around for good, from worse to good, from lower to higher, from poverty to riches, from street to the palace, from street you become an empire person. Praise the Lord, somebody. I want to give a word as I just explain to you, tell you right now that the title is Stop Counting on Insinuation. Praise the Lord, somebody. If you go to open the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1, you will see a story concerning a man called Penina. He has two wives, Hannah and Penina. They live in a city called Ramah in the scripture. As the scripture describes it, these two women, that this very man cannot marry. The first wife was barren. The Bible says it was the God Almighty who closed her womb for a purpose. Praise the Lord. And the second wife, he went further to go and marry a second wife. And this woman have more children, many children. They did not put the exact number here. Praise the Lord. Every year, the Bible said this man will leave Ramah. They will go to Shiloh, where there is the temple of the Lord. There is a priest there called Eli and the two children. These are the priests. He climbed. God said they will be priests for him. They started carrying, taking things that people brought for sacrifices. They sacrificed to God Almighty. Every year, the Bible said this family will go. They leave from Ramah, they go to Shiloh. Praise the Lord, somebody. It came to a day, this woman called Hannah, she's barren, she's been worried, troubled. That is why I said, stop being counting on insinuation. Insinuation means sight of what you hear, what people say about you because of condition, because of what you are bad. Condition that you are, maybe ugly situation you are a mess that you are passing through. Some people, they don't have a fruit of the womb. Some, they are sick, chronic disease, so many things, etc. Praise the Lord, somebody. The Bible says this woman Ekana always made jest, and I'm sorry, Penina, the second wife of Ekana, always made jest of the first wife Hannah. One day they say this woman was crying. She was at the front of the temple there, praying to God, pouring all her desire. Even up to the extent, the man, this Eli priest that was serving there by them, thought this woman was drunk. But later this woman made note to this very priest that this is what she's passing through, that she wants God to give her a child, and she will dedicate the child to God Almighty. Praise the Lord, somebody. Here, I want you to know vividly that this woman was having pain and sorrow. She was counting on an error. She was listening to side talk. This is what people said about me. I am here to encourage you. I don't know whom you are right now, whatever you are passing through that people are using to describe you. You are not counting on them. That is insinuation. Stop counting on insinuations. This is what people say about you. Maybe somebody will come and meet you. This is what people are saying about you. Sometimes they want to describe you. They are using that your ugly situation to describe you. Praise the Lord, somebody. But the Bible said, be anxious for nothing, but with prayer and supplication, made everything known to God. I want you to know the example of this woman. That is why I came up with this title, this topic, that don't count on insinuation. We can see Hannah here. She went to the temple and kneeled down in front of the altar. She began to pour all our heart desire to God Almighty. Praise the Lord, somebody. I'm here to release this good news to as many out there, Christian brothers and sisters I'm talking to. I'm not talking to the worldly people. In case you have not given your life to Christ, you want to join this community of Christ, the people of Christ, you want to give your life to God, you have to do so. Any church that is closer to where you are, go and meet the man of God there. They will tell you what to do. You have to surrender. You have to give your life to God. People are so listening to side talk these days. They are counting on insinuations instead of them to go to go on their knee to pray to God about their heart desire. Forget what people say about you. Remember in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8, the Bible says the devil, the adversary, is looking for somebody to devour. He move around. I mean, it's that devil. We don't see devil, but demon, they are using people. So when anybody come to you, they use whatever you are passing through as an ugly situation, the bad moment you are, to be laughing at you instead of you to be listening to them, those insinuations, all those worthless things. I mean, those are unreasonable. Stop being preposterous. I'm here to encourage you. All those reasonable talk that will make you shock when you hear them, remove your mind from them. Begin to focus on God. We will see here Hannah. The Bible said she went to the altar, front of the altar, and knelt down there very early in the morning. But this very priest thought she is drunk. That early this morning, madam, what are you looking for here? Are you drunk? The woman went to explain to the man of God, the priest there, that is taking care of the place they are serving God at that time. This incident happened, that this is what I'm passing through. The man said, may God be with you. May God answer all your heart desire. I am here to use this as an example to you. You that is there crying that you are looking for the fruit of the womb. Your sickness is not healed. Your marriage is not being settled. Your children's life is wayward. I don't know what you are still waiting for. As you heard this, begin to be on your knees and pour all your heart desire to God. Be anxious for nothing, but with prayer and supplication, pour all your heart desire to God Almighty. This was exactly what Hannah did. And as she prayed to God, pour all her heart desires, she even promised back to God that when I have this baby, I will bring him to your house to serve you. Though that is another thing entirely, but the area I want you to know, she poured all her heart desire. She knelt down before the presence of God. She called on God and explained all her ugly situation, bring them to God, and God answered her prayer. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, when we remember in the book of Matthew 7:7, it says, ask and it shall be given. If you go to the book of John chapter 14 verse 14, it says, ask for anything you want, he will do it. If you go to the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26, he said, bring me to remembrance all those things I said about you, because we are the Hebrew women, we are strong, we are going to deliver safely, we are not going to be buried. This woman was barren, but the Hebrew women, they can never be barren. Praise the Lord, somebody. So if you remind God for all he said about you as a special person, who are you? Like some people, they have been looking for a job, they have long finished their schools, they have been looking for a job from one place to another, they carry their certificate. There is no job. People began to use that moment to describe them. Is that all you could do? By reacting to their insinuations, by being preposterous, all those irrelevant things making you to be having shock? God forbid. I am here to encourage you, brothers and sisters in the Lord. I don't know what you are still waiting for. As you have heard this thing, news, go to the book of 1 Samuel. You will see how God bless this woman. This woman pour all her cry to God. If people are making jest of you, they are giving you names, all those side talk, your own is to go on your knee to pour them before God. Use them to tell God this is what people are doing. They are laughing at you. They are using your ugly moment, ugly situations to laugh at you. Tell God to clean those tears, to remove those stains away from you. God will do it. He did it for Anna. I don't know what you are still waiting for. I am here, brothers and sisters in the Lord, to use these things to encourage you. If you look at it in another perspective, this very woman, Hannah, the Bible said, God closed her womb. As I was going, the Holy Spirit was ministering to me, because this very man, priest, the two sons of Eli, the clan, God said they are going to be doing this sacrifice for him in his house. He made them to be priests. He made their clan that all the priests will be coming out from their clan. But this very man, the children, they were misbehaving. If you go ahead there, they were doing a lot of atrocities, making love to married women. They sacrificed. They were not doing it as God demanded. The way God wanted them to do it, God became furious. That is the reason I think God closed this woman's womb. Because when you are passing a tough time, there is a purpose for everything. I don't know if you are getting the point of what I'm trying to explain. It was then God gave this woman, because this woman passed through pain and sorrow. Somebody was mocking her, teasing her. If somebody is teasing you, there is a purpose. Something cannot just come up. We know the devil is there, looking for who he will devour. But this woman was having pain. For the Bible to say the second wife of having many children, you know how many years, at least if it is a year, 2, 3, 4, 5, for somebody to remain in such humiliation, somebody is mocking at you, all those unreasonable talk. It is not enough for you to be counting on them. Rather, use it to go on your knee and talk to God. God, because he saw already these Eli children, they are not going to continue from where their father will stop. So this woman's womb was closed. When this woman passed through tough time, she began to pour all her grievances, all her heart desire to God, that when you gave me this child, I'm bringing it to your house to serve you. I will give them back to you. She dedicated it. So she vowed to God, this baby is going to be dedicated to you to serve your house all the days of his life. Praise the Lord, somebody. That was where Samuel was born. If you go there, down there, this woman was still having other children, 3 male and 2 female. I suppose go and read it on your own. Praise the Lord, somebody. So if you are passing through on circumstances, ugly situation, there is a reason for them. I don't know if you understand. You have to go to the scripture to go and read it. So I'm here to encourage you to stop counting on insinuation. If at all, there is no reason. If those people, are they child of God? Are they worldly people? If they are worldly people, don't just count on insinuation on their bed. If it is God own, pour everything to God. Even though the worldly people, you have to still pour everything to God. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, I want you to use all these things to encourage yourself, so that next time when you are passing through stress, through difficulties, whatever you are passing through that is a mess, that is an ugly situation, that you are having pain in you, yes, those things, what you are looking unto God for is not coming. I want you to continue praying. Don't stop saying it. I remember Pastor Chris said in the city of Ephesus, so mightily through the word of God, keep on speaking the word, keep on reminding God, as Isaiah 43:26 said, remind God until that prayer is be answered. God will meet you at your end meet. Depend on how patient you are and faithful you are to God. God's word is here, amen. He is not a man or a son of man that he should lie. When he says something concerning his children, he will always bring it to pass to manifestation. I'm here to use these scriptures to encourage you, for you to be vigilant and sober. The devil, they are always there. Don't think, why is this thing happening to me? Oh, it become a shock. All these are unreasonable matters that will make you to be preposterous. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, just take heart, look, say the scriptures. Be cool, be patient, reason with God, use the word of God, meditate on them. You began to see God Almighty will pour his glory on you on the appropriate time. This very woman, God knew already that Eli's children are not going to continue from where Eli stops being a priest. God wants to use this an opportunity to bring out a good somebody that can be able to handle the things of God where in the altar of God, in that temple of God. So God used this means to make sure this woman gave him a child that will come to serve him well. So when you are passing through tough time, when you are passing through ugly situation, when people are using those your condition, ugly situation, negative conditions to laugh at you, God said you should come to him. We can use this example. I repeat again of Hannah. When her maid Elkanah, we have many Elkanahs today in the house of God. That will not stop you from going to your knee. Why are you having grievances? Why are you counting on insinuations? Stop counting on insinuations. Come to God. Put your knee down. Pray to God on your quiet time. Focus on the things of God. Be holy and have faith in God. Be patient. God will meet you at your appropriate time. I say, remain blessed as you use the word of God to move in your daily activity. Remember, I have many packages for you in my YouTube channel. My name is Mrs. Evangelist Segoma. I want you to open to my YouTube channel and search the scripture that suits you. I say, as you use it, God will continue to bless you every day. And all your heart desire, pour it to God. Need that as Anna did. Speak to God. God is there to answer you at the appropriate time. I say, God bless you as you use the word of God to move in your daily activities. For in Jesus' name, until I see you next time. Bye-bye.